This is the last session, but not the least. I'm going to showcase a metro station project, which we have modeled in my office. This is in Arizona. So you can see the PHX. PHX means Phoenix. Phoenix is the town in Arizona. SkyTrain. There is a SkyTrain over there, which takes the people from International Airport to different stations, so two, three stations over there. So multi-radius twisting tube as a potato chip, why I'm saying, because this project is unique in the nature. There is a critical geometrical aspect we have faced the challenges, because architect wanted something like if somebody is moving through airport, like in aeroplane, and somebody look at bottom, they should feel there is a potato chip over there. So that's kind of imagination the architect had given a thought. And but this was a challenging for us because geometrical challenges were there. Okay, now let's start. This is the company, Structures Online. The profile is that we do steel detailing, the steel structural modeling, let us say school, hospital, colleges, bridges, anything. We have 300 engineers in my office. We produce around 400 tons of steel fabrication drawing every day. We use 3D softwares to produce 3D model, IFC file, CNC file, BIM-based all documents data, which can be utilized by architect, general contractors and fabricators. This is my profile. I'm technical director over there. I'm having exposure of 23 years steel detailing projects, doing modeling myself, creating drawings, so making fabricators and general contractors fulfill their requirements to execute the projects in the field. So I'm a civil engineer from Institute of Engineers. My core profile is project management, and automation in detailing is a very much new budge. Actually, we are trying to utilize many technology like Excel, Dynamo, many 3D softwares, so that how can we make 3D models so fast, and how can we create 2D drawings without doing any work on that. So that kind of work I'm working on, actually. These are the projects, some of the projects. We are doing so many, but these are a few projects, like Gateway Community College, you can see. This is in Phoenix, 970 ton. Davis Monathan Air Force Hangar, it is in Tucson, 900 ton. If you move out of this hotel while going back to home, you can see a large structure over there. That is a hangar, is there in the, at the entrance of the airport. So that kind of airport hangar we have done for the US Air Force. Newport Beach in California, this is also a project. This is a Ritz-Carlton Hotel. So these are a few samples just to make you understand. So OK, now I'm going to tell you that the project which we have detailed on advanced steel, this is Autodesk product. So how, which factor product provoked us to utilize advanced steel for making 3D structure? See, output in AutoCAD native drawing format. That's so simple because everybody knows AutoCAD. And the same commands of AutoCAD is used to make 3D model. And there are handfuls of commands, few commands, just 10 commands, you learn and you make 3D. So that's the reason we given a thought, why not utilize advanced steel? Then, how we started. Starting is a big challenge. So what we had done, we formed a few people team, and then we had told them to explore the different area of the software, like 3D, 2D, file structures, and everything. And thereafter, we had executed a project over there. It took time, yes, definitely. The first project, no one knows the softwares. That is a challenging one. But just 3 to 4 months' time, we started doing the project in a very less time. The people learned very fast this software. So this is the way we have started. And you see, just in a few months, we have started doing so many projects. So we started scaling up our office accordingly also. So here's a video for you, the project which we have modeled. There are two metro stations. One is you can see coming here. This is also done by us. It has a simple structure. You can see that. And it has the public car spacious parking over there. This is the last station, rental car cab station, and that's the metro station. You can see this is not in place, this is just in model. That looks like potato chip from the top and side. So I'll tell you something about this project. There are two cars, and this is a free ride available over there. If you get down in Phoenix Sky Harbor International Airport, and if you want to go to rental car cab station, so this is a free service by the government. And 53 each, around 100 people can get into. It connects 88 gate terminals 4 to rental car cab station. It can handle 10,000 travelers every day. The pictures shows you that how this SkyTrain looks like, and the two bottom pictures you can see how this metro station is actually imagined by the architect. Now here is the model. In advanced steel software, we have utilized its all AutoCAD-based technologies and advanced steel technologies. Now you see, the right-hand side, there is a top plan. If anybody understand that how a perimeter hollow tube runs at the perimeter, it has a radius, because you can see there is a radius. Now, the same plan, if you look at from the side view at the bottom you can see, the same tube is bent in an elevation as well, which means a member has the radius in the top and the front as well. And it do have the radiuses in the front also. As you can see, the metro that you can see, there is a that's a sky train, and the platforms are there both sides. So this is the project. You can see that how these steel members are getting connected with that member. So this was a challenging task for us, because a very high-profile project. So this is just to give you imagination that what kind of a structure it is. And all members are made up of hollow tube, hollow steel tube, a heavy tube. Now this is the contract document we have received from Smith Group Architecture Company based in Arizona. And the Garnet Fleming is the engineering company who has designed this structure. And you can see that the architect had given us radius data on the top plan, and also he had given radius data on the side elevation informations. But to achieve this in a normal way, it's very difficult. Now I'll show you that how the connection took place in this building. That all members here coming from, all members which are connecting this perimeter HSS, hollow tube, you can see that how the connection is made by engineer. There is a hollow tube and there is a bucket connection. There is a bent plate. The plate is bent just like this, L-shaped, and the two bent plates are connected over there on the HSS. And the member coming from top, you can see how it is connected over there. And they had welded it. It's a very much unique kind of connection design as well. And the challenge was that this bent plate is also not going to be a simple bent plate because it has many curvatures and, you know, so the software allows us to open that bent file and show the all profile of that plate that we have detailed like this. I'll show you this video how this is modeled actually. That's the piece, actually. It was the real challenge. So there is another video. I'll show you the all members together. So that's it. This is the 3D model which we have detailed. So the next challenge was to create 2D drawings because fabricators are utilizing two-dimensional drawings, you know. So this was the next challenge on how we have tackled that. I'll show you that. The multi-radius HSST, because the tube is actually tilting slowly, slowly, slowly. It has many radiuses together. At every few inches, the radiuses keep on changing. The challenge was to make the vertical face of the hollow tube exactly vertical to the earth. This was the basically requirement of the architect, because the architect was wanting that all faces should be plumbed to the vertical. And that was the challenge, because for that reason, we have to make so many radius at every few inches. So we have, okay, sorry. So you can see the plan. We have shown the plan view, the front elevation view, and there are few sections at the right side you can see. those sections are able to tell fabricator that every fit, what angle that the twist is required for that particular HSS. This is one of the pieces out of that full complete metro station, because there are so many members, around 25 members are there. So this is one of the pieces, 2D soft drawings. So how fabricator is going to utilize this drawing, he can see the angles and the degrees at every length so that he can use the machines to make it possible. So this is the drawing, just to make you understand. And we have given them isometric view also and all points so that they can locate. Now, this was the project. OK, so now I'm going to cover a new topic called BIM management. This was the BIM-based project, because in America also, most of the projects are BIM-based. The general contractors are asking so many BIM data with the 3D model. So what we have done is, you can see, I'm going to tell you that how the load 400 based beam management we have done. We have placed all the information required by the load 400 information. Load means LOD, means level of development. The BIM is a concept, actually. BIM is not a software, BIM is nothing. BIM is actually a concept. So a model which can include, these are the parameters which we have shown in the model, like welds, bolt information, bent plate information, like all CNC file information, CNC data, KISS data, purchase order, labor code, barcode, all those information, if that is included in the model while doing that in advanced steel, whatever we are doing. And that model goes to the general contractor, and he is going to utilize for his all fabrication and erection purpose. Then it becomes LOD 400 level model. And we provide IFC file to them as well. So IFC is what? Industry Foundation Class, that is supported by most of the 3D softwares today. And this is managed by Build a Smart Company, that IFC file. And the general contractors are generally looking for origin data, RFI management, all sequence information, like whenever the construction is taking place, that which are the item has to be constructed first, which are item to be constructed next. So these all informations can be included in IFC format as well. So that we do. Now, I would like to conclude here this session that what the vision we have. The first topic is parametric modeling. As I told you that we want to reduce the modeling time, the 3D modeling time, and 2D drawings creation and editing time. So for that reason, we are going to leverage the technologies like Dynamo, which is integrated with Advanced Steel. And in Dynamo, you can write a code to make 3D model automatically. So you don't have to physically, you don't have to create the model. You have to simply write the grids, members, all geometrical aspect. You have to simply write the code just like, and then the model is getting ready. And then so far 2D output drawings are concerned, for that also, you can write the codes in that Dynamo and that certain kind of setting so that it can allow us to automate your required data, in 2D format. The second we want to explore is model exchange with Revit and Advanced Steel. See, the Revit, most of the projects which we are getting from America today are having the Revit model. And we are able to export that Revit model data into the Advanced Steel so that we don't have to do any more wireframe part. We have to directly jump into the connection part, and then the model is getting ready. So that area is very nice and very important. So that we are exploring and we have done some projects as well. And drawing style manager is again a feature inside the Advanced Steel software which allow you to automate your 2D drawing output according to your custom requirement. Because every client, every fabricator looks for the drawing in a certain format. Where should be section, what are the part marks, what are the dimensions, the part locating, all informations which can be automated, and that we have done up to a certain extent. But still, we are exploring, actually. The BIM services, also, we have the vision. Because the 3D model we are providing them, LOD 400, but still we have to go for LOD 500, level of development 600, where my general contractor can utilize those 3D model for the building construction faster. See, 4D beams is what? Like class detections and the scheduling, like you know Gantt chart, all they manage. So that can be integrated with 3D model. And the 5D is what? The cost impact, that what the cost is going to occur in the construction period, like labor, timing, all cost aspect, if it is included, then it becomes 5D. That we have a vision that we are moving towards to make to add those information in that 3D model, which we are able to make in advanced steel. So that's the way we can provide services to the general contractors and you know erectors in the field as well, apart from steel fabricators. So that's the presentation I had for the today, and I hope you enjoyed this project. Okay. This was a very exciting, geometrical, challenging project. So my team is here, few people who had actually executed this project. So I'd like to bring, I'd like to call those people here. We have done thousands of projects so far, but always we love the geometrical challenges. So we have chosen this project to showcase you that whatever the geometrical constraints are there, the advances are there and the softwares are there, using a lot of good technology like SP-Line, Extrude, many commands are there in that software that you can utilize to realize the dream of the architect. So here are the people, my team.